Greetings, Eric Backup. Thanks for coming back and checking out my videos. I just wanted to do a quick video on pancreatic problems. Just last week alone, I had three patients, in three separate countries with a very similar problem. They had a problem with digestion, a problem that nobody else could sort out, a problem that stayed there, ranging from one case in America for 10 years to another case in a lady in the United Kingdom who's had the problem for 3 years. So I see this quite a lot in people. So these are the things I look for: poor appetite, weight loss, bloating, a continual issue with food, and over time, being able to consume less and less and less foods when you're down to just a handful of foods like chicken or lettuce or foods like that that don't aggravate you anymore. And these are the sort of patients that go from one doctor to another doctor to another doctor to a GI doctor to a chiropractor, to a shaman, to whatever. To a tarot card reader or to, whatever. Anywhere they can go to get relief. The case I had last week had been to over 20 doctors, this particular patient. She was quite unwell. She'd lost a ton of weight. She had no appetite anymore. She had a terrible gut problem. She got down to literally four foods that she could eat. When I authorized a stool test and we got that back, we found she had a marker called pancreatic elastase 1. And it was about 85. It was well under 100. So PE1, or pancreatic elastase 1, is a marker that basically shows you what the function of the pancreas, the exocrine function, is like, or the digestive capacity of this organ is like. So this enzyme is not degraded by digestion. So you pass it out. The pancreas makes it. You pass it out through the bowel. It remains unchanged. So we can tell by the level of PE1, if you've got very poor digestion, average digestion, or good digestion. So the PE1 ideally should be over 500, but anywhere between 1 to 200, it's actually very poor function. Anything under 100, well, that's shocking. It's very bad function, often hospitalization. So the low PE1 enzyme is a red flag to a pancreas problem. One of my patients in America, I'm catching up with next week, we've finally helped this guy. After many, many years of feeling sick and spending so much money, he's finally got now a great result. He's gaining weight, his brain function's coming back, his appetite's improving. Basically, it's changed his whole life. And all we did was we found the PE1 marker. In this case, I think was about 116. And I said to this guy, wow, that's a bit low, isn't it? And when we looked back at an earlier report from, I think, a few years ago, we found also a low PE1 marker in a test he'd done, but no doctor paid any attention to it. Helping this guy with supplementary pancreatic enzymes has changed his whole world. I'm about to start on the case in the UK with a lady as well with pancreatic glandular supplements and specific pancreatic enzymes to restore her function, and the outcome will be very favorable. So if you've got a gut problem that nobody can seem to solve, no matter what top person you go and see, get your PE1, pancreatic elastase 1, PE1 enzyme checked, just in case there is a problem with it. And it could make the world of difference for you by restoring the pancreatic function, especially if you get bloating and you feel sick and you've got no appetite and you've lost weight and the bowel's playing up and it's been going on and on and on for a long time. It may not be candida, it may not be parasites, it may be a pancreatic problem. Check it out. Thanks for tuning in.